get a £5 free bet every week with Offer Club from William Hill. Simply stake a total of £20 or more across the week on pre-match football accumulators with four or more selections, and you'll get a £5 free bet on the Friday. Join William Hill Offer Club on mobile or online now.
You're with middleweight contender Jason Quigley. Now, Jason, when are we getting back inside that ring, my man?
We're going to be back inside that ring very shortly. We'll be looking to see Team Quigley back out in December again. Staying in the gym, staying ready, and I'm ready for action.
Now, the middleweight division is wide open. The biggest fight we're talking about is Canelo Alvarez versus Gennady Golovkin. Triple G is supposed to be returning to the ring on December 10th. His opponent was supposed to be Danny Jacobs, but it's looking more like this fight may not be taking place. What are your thoughts on that potential bout and why it's not happening?
To be honest, you know, I don't know the real reason why this fight isn't going to happen. Maybe it all comes down to money and stuff like that at the end of the day, but, you know, boxing needs to get back to the way it was in the old days. Champions fight champions no matter what. Whoever has belts, they fight the other guy that has belts. It's all about getting, as Triple G says, all the belts. Do you know what I mean? And that's what it's all about. It's about being world champion. Not only being world champion, but being the best out there and being a multiple world champion. You know, the Danny Jacobs fight, who do I think wins it? I think Triple G wins that fight. But can Danny Jacobs feel like a real champion, you know, with that WBA belt if he doesn't fight Triple G as well, you know? So it's going to be a great fight if it ever happens. It might not happen now with the way things are going. Reasons why, we don't know. I hope it does get made because it's going to show who the real middleweight champion is out there.
Now, let's talk about prize fighting. You are prize fighters. You guys fight for a prize. You guys fight for money. We understand that. You're here to make money. You're here to make a living. However, like you just mentioned before, a lot of fighters aren't fighting for the legacy. They're fighting to keep that undefeated record. They're fighting to make sure they get that next big payday. We don't see any fighters really willing to take the risk or going to take that risk to become something great or to get a bigger fight, a bigger money fight. You got a fighter here by the name of Jesse Magdaleno who's fighting for a world title on November 5th, and he's not taking the easy route. He's fighting a proven and probably one of the best of our era, Nonito Donaire. And Nonito Donaire seems like he's got his head back inside that game. He seems like he's motivated and ready to prove that he's still one of the best fighters on this planet. What are your thoughts when you see fighters such as Jesse Magdaleno, who's willing to prove himself at such a relatively young age, at such a relatively young start to his pro career, and you see other fighters like Danny Garcia, who are accomplished champions, but yet aren't really doing anything in the sport to, you know, get more fans. And if anything, we're losing fans.
Yeah, you know, obviously Jesse's a great friend of mine. He trains here in the gym alongside me and everything. And these are opportunities that you have to take. These are the opportunities that come along that can prove your greatness, prove your champion spirit and everything like that. For me, you know, when I'm gray and old, I want to look back and I want to say I fought the best, I beat the best, and I was the best. I don't want to look back and say that I picked this fighter or I picked that fighter and, you know, I worked my way around being a world champion. I want to fight the best, I want to be the best, and I want to know when I go to bed at nighttime, when I put my head in that pillow and go to sleep, that everything's clear in my head, that I know that I was in with the best, I fought the best, and I beat the best. That's what it's all about to me. But also, you know, of course, to get to that level, you have to be smart, and that's why it's important to have a great team around you, because I think most fighters just want to fight the best and biggest fight. You know, it can come down to a lot of teams on the outside, guiding them here and guiding them there, you know, which is correct. You know, it's a living, it's a dangerous sport as well. You got to make your money, and you want to come out here you want to come out of this sport being able to talk right and to be able to still be all switched on upstairs and everything like that. And that's what's most important, to be able to come out of this sport at the end of it with money in the bank, being a world champion, and having all your health there as well.
What are your thoughts when you think of, and I know we just mentioned this before, but Floyd Mayweather, he's fabricated this blueprint of retaining an undefeated record. Fighters feel that without an undefeated record, you're not going to get those big money fights. There's so much money to be made. Why would any fighter want to risk his undefeated record?
That's basically just down to the fighter themselves, you know, deep down in their heart, what they really want. If they're going to be a true warrior, a true champion, a true great and go into the history books, doesn't matter what their team says around them, they're going to want to fight the best out there. They're going to want to get into the ring with the best out there. And that's the way I feel. I want to get into that ring with the best man on the planet and see where I'm at and to see how good I really am. For myself, not for nobody else,
right.
Just for myself. You know, and Floyd Mayweather, people are looking at him like he's been the best man ever, and his record, everything shows that, the money he's made. When he gets into that ring, and when I look at him as a fighter, I look at him as one of the most smartest fighters out there. You know, very, very smart. Very, very smart. And, you know, very intelligent in the ring. And I think that's very important, you know, as a fighter. He's coming out of the game, one of the most wealthiest sportsmen in the world. You
exactly.
know, he's fit, he's healthy, he looks clean. You know, that's the perfect way to play the boxing game. For me, if that's what you want to do, that's what you want to
right.
do. You know, I want to be the best there is, but I'm not afraid to get in there with the best and to put my record on the line or anything like that, you know, because you have to look up to Floyd Mayweather. He did fight some great fighters in
yeah.
his time, and he put his record on the line. You know what I mean? It's not as if that he protected his record all throughout his career. He fought some great fighters. He put his record on the line. He might have picked the times when it suited him, but if you can get away with that, why not?